Today we're going to talk about the TMC2225 on the SKR Pro version 1.2. Essentially, the 2226 is very similar to a TMC2208. So I'm going to zoom in real quick here to show you what it looks like. So as you can see, it's the first version of it, and it's a little different. The potentiometer is on the opposite side, and the enable pin is the opposite to that, and that would be located right here. So what we need to figure out now is how to configure this on the SKR Pro version 1.2. So we need to figure out what the jumper pins are and where the enable pins are for the X stepper, the Y stepper, the Z stepper, E0, E1, and E2. So to do that, what we're going to do is we're going to go over to the web browser. And inside the web browser, you can see that there's the SKR Pro version 1.1. But what we need to do is actually click on this for 1.2 and then the manual. And over here, you'll find the manual. So inside the manual, what you'll see in a moment when it loads is that there's a lot of information about the board. So I'm going to skip over a lot for the moment. And I'm going to scroll down to the point where we first check on the actual jumper for USB power supply. You cannot use the USB power when using the stepper. You have to use direct power, which is this configuration. And I'll point this out on the board in a moment. So let's scroll down a little bit further and see if we can find some information about the board. Now here's the outline of the actual steppers. So you see that there's the Z motors have two connectors that you can use for your Z axis stepper. And then down here, they have an EN. That shows where the pin is located. So you can see that on each one of the actual diagram. So here's where the enable pin would be. So now that we know that, now we need to look into the actual stepper type. Now we're not going to use step dir, which is step direction mode. We're going to be using UART mode, which is right here. And the jumper setting is right here. So we're going to go back to our workbench, and we're going to set that up. So what I need to do is actually pop off the jumpers. So to do this, I'm using a dental pick because it's rather easy to work with. So I'll pop these out. And now that they're out, I need to put the jumper in for UART mode, which is going to be over here. So I'm going to push that down. And as you can see on the steppers right now, I have cooling fins. So you also want to run a fan on these to keep them cool. But to install it, you're going to look at the driver, being the stepper board, and you're going to see that red is on one side. So that's the orientation that you're going to match up when you actually plug it in. So it's just a little bit of thumb pressure, and that's all you have to do. So I'm going to connect the DuPont connector for the axis. Remember, this does not have sensorless homing. I just want to point that out. Now we need to actually power it. So I'm going to pop this up, and you can see that there's motor power and there's board power. So to connect this, what I'm going to have to do is actually connect these cables from the PSU or power supply unit. So the red one is voltage, and notice how I marked the bolt red so that you know which one you're connecting. And then the black one is ground, so I'll slide that in and I'll tighten that down as well. So that's the motor power. Now we need to do the power for the actual board logic. So I'm going to connect the red again, and I'm going to tighten that down, and then I'm going to connect the black. Once these are connected, we're going to put down a little guide to control the actual ability for us not to touch it. And this was the jumper I was talking about. There's USB power and there's direct power. So USB is actually over here. And I'll show you with the demonstration. Now I'll unplug it and I'll plug it into direct power. And you'll see there's just a light that's used to say that it's plugged in. So this was unplugged the entire time for safety. So before we actually do anything, I'm gonna unplug this for a moment and we're gonna set this up to load the firmware. So I'm gonna pop out the SD drive and I'm going to use this little converter by Rocket Tech. And I'll let you know right now, no one's paying me or sponsoring me to do this tutorial, but I will place Amazon affiliate links in the description for your convenience. So I'm gonna place this in the computer. And now I'm gonna go over to VS Code. And inside VS Code, what I'm gonna do is I'm actually going to load the Marlin firmware that I downloaded. So I'm gonna click on Explorer, then Open Folder, then I'm gonna go to my Downloads folder, my Marlin folder, my next Marlin folder, and then Select Folder. Once that's selected, we need to find our motherboard. So I'm gonna click on Marlin, then Source, then Core, then Boards.h. Inside Boards.h, I'm gonna do a search on SKR_Pro, and you can see that our version of the board is right here for 1.2. So I'm going to copy that. I'm going to close out of the boards.h. I'm going to minimize core, source, and then go to configuration.h. Inside configuration.h, I'm going to search on motherboard, and I'm going to highlight the RAMPS board and then paste our board there. Then I need to go to the serial port and change that to -1. And then I need to search on A4988. And that'll bring us to the steppers. So we're working with the X stepper, so I'm gonna remove the comment. Next, because our stepper is not specified in the list, it's the exact same as a TMC2208, so I'm gonna copy that, and I'm gonna paste this right here. Over here, I'm gonna show you something real quick. It's default access steps per unit. This is gonna be tied to configuration advanced.h, so if I search on 800 here, you'll see what I'm talking about. So it's a couple of searches down, but here's the actual stepper. So you can see the 16, that is actually tied to this value of 80. So if we change this to 160, that means we need to change this value to 32. If we change this to 320, then we have to change this value to 64, and so on and so forth, just so you understand. So now we need to turn on debugging so we can make sure that our actual stepper is working. So I'm gonna search on TMC_debug. And as you can see right here, it's monitor driver status, so I need to remove the comment. And over here, this is the actual G code we'll be using to check it. It's M122, and that'll give us the actual driver status. We also have to do this a second time, so I'm gonna find the second instance of this, and it's TMC debug, so I'm gonna remove the comment there. And then what we're gonna do is set up the actual compile. So to do that, what we need to do is go over to platform.io.ini. We need to search on our default environment. So I'm gonna search on SKR_Pro. And here's our default environment. So I'm going to copy that. And then I'm going to scroll back up to the top. I'm going to highlight the Mega 2560. And I'm going to paste it over that. Now, before we actually build, we want to make sure that our .pio is cleaned out because it has the Mega in there right now for the 2560. So I'm going to click on this. And then I'm going to click on the checkbox. Now, this may fail the first time that you compile because something might be out of order for the actual compile. If it does, compile a second time. And if it does break after the second time, go to the very first error that you encounter and correct that, as the other ones may be a cascade of errors that occur because of that. So this time it looks like it's working quite well. So you can see right here that the SKR Pro is building, and then it's populating this folder over here, and we have our firmware.bin. So I'm going to right click on that, and I'm going to go to reveal in File Explorer. Then I'm going to right click again, and I'm going to send it to our D drive. On our D drive, you can see there's a firmware.cur in all capital letters, and there's a firmware.bin. The firmware.bin is the binary file for loading, whereas the firmware.cur or current is the firmware that loaded previously that was a binary. So it was renamed to firmware.bin. Firmware.bin to firmware.cur in all capital letters. So now that that's done, we're going to go back over to the desktop. We're going to pop out the drive. We're going to remove it. And we're going to place it inside here. Then we're going to connect the USB. And we'll connect the power. Now that it's energized, please don't touch the board because it can be dangerous. But we're going to go over to Pronerface. And inside Pronerface, what we need to understand right now is because we're defaulted to COM port 1, is what our COM port should be. Now, normally you would click here and it might be 17. But to confirm it, we can actually click on Device Manager. So I'm going to go to Device Manager, open it up, and I'm going to check the COM port. And as you can see, it is 17. So I'm going to connect to 17. And it says connecting, and printer is now online. So to check it for the steppers, we can type M122 and enter. And as you can see right here, it says testing X connection OK. So we're good there. So now we can actually test the movement of this. So what we're going to do is we're going to advance by 10 and see what happens. And notice how it's moving in the direction towards where maybe your end stop may be. In that case, what you'll need to do is actually go over to the VS Code, and you may have to change the direction, so I'll point this out real quick. So if you go to configuration.h and you search on invert, what you'll see down here is the ability to change the direction. So if you change the false to a true or the true to a false, you can address that to move towards your end stop. So if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe, and thank you for your time.